हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू एन यूनिवर्स डबल टू। फर्स्टली सब्सक्राइब टू गेट मोर वीडियोज़ ऑन मोर टॉपिक्स एन यूनिवर्स डबल टू एंड फॉर गेटिंग द नोटिफिकेशन फॉर अपलोडिंग ऑफ न्यू वीडियोज़ ऑन वेरियस टॉपिक्स। लेट्स स्टार्ट विद दिस वीडियो। टूडे वी ट्राई टू सॉल्व अ न्यूमेरिकल दैट इज बेस्ड ऑन हीट पम्प, हीट इंजन एंड रेफ्रिजरेटर। द स्टेटमेंट ऑफ द न्यूमेरिकल इज एन आइस प्लांट वर्किंग ऑन ए रिवर्स्ड कार्नोट हीट पम्प। So here one term is important, that is reverse Carnot heat pump. It means that is a working as a refrigerator, that is the reversed. Produces 15 tons of ice per day. So it is given 15 tons of ice per day. So we need to convert it into kilojoule per minute. The ice is formed from water at 0 degree Celsius and the formed ice is maintained at 0 degree Celsius. The heat is rejected to the atmosphere is 25 degree Celsius. The heat pump used to run the ice plant is coupled to a Carnot engine. So here heat pump that is coupled with Carnot engine, which absorb heat from a source which is maintained at 220 degree Celsius by burning liquid fuel of 44,500 kilojoule per kg calorific value and reject the heat to the atmosphere. Determine power developed by the engine and fuel consumed per hour. Take enthalpy of fusion of ice that is equal to 334.5 kilojoule per kg. So here one thing is common between these two heat pump, reverse heat pump or heat engine. The heat is rejected at 25 degree Celsius in both the cases. So the Carnot engine that is higher temperature is given 220 degree Celsius, lower temperature is 25 degree Celsius, and the lower temperature for the reverse heat pump that is 0 degree and higher temperature for the reverse heat pump that is the 25 degree. And now we try to solve it. So here this is the arrangement, this is heat engine. So in heat engine this is the higher temperature 220 plus 273 that is 493 Kelvin, and this is the T1 temperature that is given. Next this is the lower temperature T2, 25 plus 273 298 Kelvin, that is the T2. This heat engine that is coupled with heat pump, that is the reverse heat pump, so its lower temperature is 0 degree Celsius. So 0 plus 270 273 Kelvin, this is 273 Kelvin, and exhaust at 25 degree Celsius. So 225 plus 273 equal to 298 Kelvin, that is the T4 temperature. So here Q1 that is the heat that is supplied to the heat engine for getting the work done, and Q2 is the rest amount of heat that is exhausted at 25 degree, and this is the work done that would that is need to be done on reverse heat engine for getting the refrigerating effect, for extracting the Q3 heat, and Q4 is the heat exhausted at temperature 25 degree Celsius. So firstly we need to calculate power developed by the engine. So it is given amount of ice reproduced per day, that is 15 ton. Firstly it convert into kilojoule per minute. So the amount of heat removed by the heat pump, that is 15 into 1000 into 334.5 divided by 24 into 60. So this is 1000 to convert ton into kg, and 334.5, this is the latent heat of ice, 24 hours 60 minute. So totally we get 3484.4 kilojoule per minute. This is the Q3. Q3 that is extracting from the source for the production of the ice. So this is the Q3 heat that is extracted by doing the work W. So here COP of the heat pump, so this is not the heat pump, this is the reverse heat pump. So reverse heat pump that is working like a refrigerator. So in case of refrigerator, Q3 is the desired effect, refrigeration effect. So this is Q3 upon W, and in terms of temperature T3 upon T4 minus T3. T3 is given 273, T4 is given 298 minus 273. So here we get W equal to Q3 into 298 minus 273 by 273, and finally we get 319.08 kilojoule per minute. So this is the work done kilojoule per minute for getting the power So this work must be developed by the Carnot engine. As we can see here, this is the W that can be done by the engine. So for getting it into kilowatt, divide this figure with by 60, then we get 5.3 kilojoule per second. And as we know, joule per second, that is the watt, so it becomes 5.3 kilowatt. So thus power developed by the engine, that is 5.3 kilowatt. Now second part is fuel consumed per hour. Fuel consumed per hour means ki how much Q1 is supplied or at to the engine, and we need to find out the quantity of fuel consumed per hour. So for getting this parameter, we need to find out the efficiency of Carnot engine. As we know, the efficiency of Carnot engine, that is equal to work done upon the heat supplied, and this is also equal to, in terms of temperature, higher temperature minus lower temperature divided by lower temperature. So these temperatures are given and we get W upon Q1 equal to 0.396, and from here we get Q1 equal to W upon 0.396, and W is also calculated in the last step, that is 5.3, and finally we get Q1 equal to 13.38 kilojoule per second. So for getting this is per second, to convert into per hour, then we get 13.38 into 60 converted into min, into 60 converted into hour. So we get 48168 kilojoule, that is the heat that is supplied to the heat engine for getting the work done, W. Now we need to find out the quantity of fuel consumed per hour. So for that, we divide 48168 divided by 44500, then we get that is equal to 1.082 kg per hour. This is the fuel consumed per hour. So friends, today we have learnt about the numerical based on heat pump, refrigerator and heat engine. If you like this video, share among your friends and students. Thanks for watching. Subscribe to get more video on more topics and Universe 22. Thank you. Have a nice day.